Also, measure the inside diameter of the cylinder liner according to the instruction manual. Measure the inside diameter of the cylinder liner with a specified measuring tool. Use the measuring tool of the inside diameter position to measure the specified measuring position in the two directions respectively. Remove the piston pin from the removed piston for checking and maintenance. First, remove the piston pin circlips using pliers. Detach the piston pin while supporting the connecting rod. Secondly, remove the piston ring. Turn over the piston and detach the cover of the piston cooling chamber. Check and maintain the removed parts. Firstly, eliminate the carbon deposited on the outside of the piston and the scale in the cooling chamber. Secondly, check the piston by the penetrate test for cracks on its top surface and ring grooves. If any of them are found with abnormal state, change the parts. Measure the dimension of each piston part and of the piston pin according to the instruction manual. If any of them are used beyond the usage limit, change the parts. Check the connecting rod. First, check the contacts and looseness and fit of the piston pin metals. Also check the condition of crank pin metal. Check the contact on the rear and mating surface of each metal, and also check for seizure and embedded form matters on the sliding surface of each metal. Check for cracks, wear, and scratches on the serration mating surface of big end and bolts of connecting rod. To prevent the bolts from being broken due to fatigue, replace them every 20,000 hours, even if the appearance is normal. Measure each part of the connecting rod according to the instruction manual. If any of them are used beyond the usage limit, change the parts. After finishing the check and maintenance, exchange the necessary parts and assemble the piston and the connecting rod. Put the cover on the piston cooling chamber. At this time, fit its holes on the top of the piston at the marking side pump side. Renew the bolt and the Belleville spring and then tighten them. Assemble the piston ring. Incorporate the oil ring with its coil joint shifted 180 degrees from its cut. Be careful not to mistake a setting order of second ring and top ring. Incorporate the piston rings with their marked sides facing upwards and their cuts shifted 120 degrees from those of the adjacent rings. Incorporate the piston and the connecting rod while aligning their set marks to each other and insert the piston pin. At this time, incorporate the piston pin circlip with its opening facing straight down. Set the crank pin metals on the connecting rod and metal cap. At this time, don't apply lube oil on the rear of the crank pin metals.